The sights and sounds of Christmas invite us once again to celebrate the birth of Christ. Friends and family gather to attend church together, to share a special meal, to exchange gifts and greeting cards, and to enjoy festive decorations. All of this to announce the season of joy, peace, and goodwill to all men. This is a season of remembering God's promise. God made a way, the only perfect way, for us to have a relationship with Him. Scripture tells us in Isaiah chapter 9, the people have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear. We read from Scripture, Luke 2, and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you great news of great joy that will be good for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom His favor rests." Jesus left the richness and peace of a perfect heaven in exchange for poverty and heartache of the human condition. His life was a simple yet perfect open book of God's love toward us. For the Son of God came as a man to make men the sons of God. How do you see Him? In what ways do we at First Christian Church of the Beaches perceive the face of God?
Children see Him crossed and crowned.
In the stillness of a cold Judean night, the prophet's vision was fulfilled in a small village called Bethlehem. It would cradle the very presence of God. The baby born that night would be born a virgin from the family of King David, and he was God's promise to all nations. Can you imagine how the father felt as he gave up his only son? He gave him up knowing Jesus would not be loved or worshiped as he should have been. This man of sorrows, now acquainted with the suffering rejection by the very people he came to deliver. Yet the Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost. But first, he came as a vulnerable infant, helpless and dependent, secure in Joseph's rough carpenter's hands and nursed by his young mother, Mary.
Thank you.
Come and adore him, Christ the Lord. But wait, Jesus claimed that his kingdom was not of this world. While on earth, Jesus said, if anyone would come after me, he must first deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. In this, Jesus showed us the very nature of why he came to earth. It was to lead us back to the Father. He loved us to the point of dying on a rugged cross. By work and deed, Jesus revealed God's plan to adopt us into his eternal family, for he rose on Easter, victorious over death itself. In John 14, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. His own cousin, John the Baptist, said as he baptized Jesus, Behold, the Lamb of God, which takes away the sins of the world. He came that we would have life more abundant to him, to know real joy, true love, perfect peace, and hope. Hope for tomorrow, for he is there. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Oh,
He continues to seek and to save that which is lost. Maybe you have lost hope or wrestle with the uncertainty of your future. Whatever you need, your circumstance, whatever guilt you bear or burden you carry, whatever problem you're facing, Jesus promised to meet you right where you are and give eternal life and purpose, if only you will accept him. God's grace is in the gift of his Son at Christmas, that all who believe in him might be saved. Come, let us adore him.